SPAC business has been a very strong business overall in the market in 2020 and continues actually even stronger now in Asia and Europe. So it was led by the US, but it's, we see a lot of activity. We had a very good year in 2020. 21 has now seen some other of our competitors. We are, I think we are number four, number five right now, but it's a clear alternative to traditional IPOs. It's an alternative to private equity. It's good to have SPAC as an alternative, I think, and it opens opportunities for entrepreneurs. It opens opportunities for investors to participate in a different manner. So clearly, this is very important that the compliance and due diligence efforts are sound. But I feel very comfortable about how we have been doing this business. And from that perspective, I think there is more opportunities ahead of us. And we'll have to see how 2021 will continue.
Is there going to be a boom in Europe of SPAC activity, or are the markets different compared to the United States, perhaps a little less open and a bit more highly regulated?
Well, one of the issues in Euroland and also in Switzerland is negative interest rates, and that doesn't help the SPAC business because obviously at the beginning it's cash. And but we do see definitely a pickup in interest in Europe in SPACs, and we'll see more in 21 than we saw in 20. But there are some structural disadvantages compared to the US dollar because of the negative rates. We see a lot of activity in Asia around SPACs, so I think actually Asia will be more active than Europe.